I'm Ryan Johnson. I'm president of RMJ Tactical. I've been forging for 30 years now. I make knives, tomahawks for U.S. military and law enforcement. I design for CRKT, and I introduced the concept of Forged by War to CRKT. I started making knives and tomahawks when I was a kid. I studied them, I read about them, I did my book reports on them. I was the kid that dressed up like a ninja and had a machete strapped to his back running through the woods. And I just loved weapons. So I have a deep interest in ancient weapons. When I think about design, when I'm designing something, I'm drawing all the way back to my childhood. As far as balance and flow, I'm a degreed engineer, and so that's part of what I draw on. Part of it's the history, part of it's the craft of just doing it enough to where you know what works and what doesn't work. The Forged by War story starts out a few years ago. I got a call from a friend named Ashton Naylor, who was then Colonel Naylor at John F. Kennedy Special Warfare Center and School. He asked me if I could come and help teach a class on making knives and tomahawks, and that sounded like an awesome opportunity. So I went to Fort Bragg with the guys from the RMJ Tactical crew, and we taught a class to the cadre at the famous Range 37, the Special Forces Range. They were super awesome students. And so over the months and years later, I would get pictures from these guys of knives they made. And I looked at the knives, I really liked them. And I thought the designs were simple and effective. And I think they were effective because they were simple.
Ryan Johnson's influence started because, when I started blacksmithing, he was my first teacher. He had asked me if there was ever a knife that I wished I had during any of my deployments overseas. And I drew it and showed it to him. That conversation led to the Forged by War project.
I thought, why not partner these guys up with CRKT to get really good designs? Designs that were coming from somebody with the authority to talk on a design like that.
As a military guy, in Rangers and Special Forces and Special Operations, we all carry knives. We know how we want it to fit on our kit. We know how we want it to feel in our hand, and we know what we want that knife to do once we use it. I just applied those principles to how I design a knife.
When you have that marriage of combat experience and craft, it becomes a perfect storm where something very special comes out of it. And the reason it's special is because they're not just forging knives, they're forging themselves.
Something beautiful about getting a material that is unforgiving and heating it, forging it, and then just working it out.
You know, it's hard to get a Michael Rodriguez knife. He doesn't sell them. He gives them away to guys going off to fight, or they go to charity. Same thing with Austin. Austin, it's hard to get one of his knives, or Darren Saroy, or Elmer. They're one guy shops. They do small quantities. They're not in it for the money to begin with. So taking part of the profits from the project and putting it into charities of the maker's choice, it's the icing on the cake.
It lets us contribute to today's young warfighters in any way we can through our experience and our knowledge, because all the tools we wanted to craft were things that at one point in time were tools we desperately needed and would have really made our mission better, more successful.
To be able to make something and know that it's making a difference is what it's all about.